There are so many like us that share a common history. Both before us and after, there have been thousands that have walked these corridors. Like us, they share so many of the same memories. They also ate the same food. They studied in the same magnificent buildings. They played the same games and walked the same leafy pathways as we did. There was so much in common for all of us at the Dune School. But there was one thing that was solely ours, something that belonged to no one else. It was that we belonged to a very special family. We belonged to the batch of 1982. Twenty-five years later, our memories of that family may have faded just a little bit, but like pictures in an album, those faces and names will stay with us forever. Those pictures reveal a time when we thought we were invincible. We shared the arrogance of youth. Nothing we could do was wrong. It was a time when we had hair on our heads and we thought we looked like rock stars. The old photos remind us of the ridiculous names we gave each other, most of which have stuck, unfortunately, to this day. It was a time when we could outrun most, no matter that our kids can do it now. A time when hitting a cricket ball or even one's opponent was our only pressing concern. Looking at those old pictures makes us realize that whether one wore that special blazer, tie and scarf or not, it didn't really matter. What did matter was taking part, regardless of how ludicrous we might have appeared. If nothing else, looking back is still worth a laugh or two. It was a time when we were proud of ourselves and of each other. Proud that we were a band of brothers, even if that term was not strictly true. For us, life was just beginning. And like most young families, we thought we were immortal. We thought we had forever. But forever, of course, is just another word. As the old albums show, there are pictures of close friends who are no more. Pictures which will keep their faces frozen in time. A time when the 82 family was complete. And it was complete then. Complete and as tightly knit as a team. Twenty-five years later, our memories of that family may have faded just a little bit. But those old pictures stand as the only visual record of a time for friendship. A time when we didn't give a damn. A time when happiness was a very simple emotion. It was a time to laugh. A time for fun. A time that belonged only to us. A time for the family of 1982.